Children, we are learning about lesson 4. In this class, next part we are going to know about the fishing village on the coastal plains. There are so many villages in the coastal plains. In some villages, the people go for fishing. So this is their livelihood. Here, how oceans are saline in taste. Why oceans are salt in taste? Because it contains several minerals and salt dissolved in it. And oceans are main source of rainfall. Because of these oceans, we get the rains. Already, you know about the water cycle. How rains falls on the earth. These oceans are the main source for rainfall. And also storehouses of fish and other seafoods. We can find so much of seafoods from oceans. For trading also, oceans are very important. The national highway, these some fishes will be transported under goods, oil. So many are transported on fishes, non-oceans. So, for trading also, these oceans are very important. Next, we are going to learn about fishing in one village we are given, Bhavanapadu village, which is in Andhra Pradesh, and study the life of the people living near the ocean. What is the name of that village? Bhavanapadu. It is in Andhra Pradesh. We are going to learn about the people, those who are living in that village, how the life of the people. Fishing. It is 4 in the morning. Appalgonna's wife, Danamma, wakes him up and gives him some rice meal to eat by 5 a.m. After which, Appalgonna is ready to go out to the sea. Here, one family living, about that family we are learning. Appalgonna and his wife, Danamma. So, he wakes him up at early morning, 5 o'clock, and given some rice to eat because he is going to, he is going for fishing on the ocean. Appalgonna is ready to go out to the sea. His friends wait for him on the beach. All of them are poor fishermen. Appalgonna and his friends all are going to catch the fishes on the sea. Appalgonna and his friends. His friends are waiting for him at the sea beach. They don't want any boats or nets. For fishing, what they want? Boats and nets. What they want? Boats and nets are compulsory for fishing. They don't have the boats and nets. They work on Tanda Rao's mechanical boat. So, Tanda Rao has a mechanical boat. These people work on that boat. All together, there are 20 members on the boat. How many members on that boat go for fishing? 20 members. Tanda Rao also joins them and works along with them. Here, Tanda Rao also joins with them and works with them. The boat had already been made ready the day before with all the necessary things properly loaded in it. So necessary things also should they took that necessary things. Why? Because they are going on the sea. Before the day only they packed that all necessary things what they want. Before launching into the sea, they check the engine, the rope puller, the additional stock of diesel and also put packages down. Before going to the sea, what they check? What they check? Diesel and engine, rope puller, engine, the boat, mechanical boat, no? That one. So, they have to check that diesel, engine, rope puller, everything they have to check. And the food packages, what they took that food, that also. They pray to the goddess in whom they have strong faith. They goddess. On which goddess they have faith? They pray to the goddess. Tatara owns this boat which he purchased from Markanda in Odisha. From where does the Tatara bought this mechanical boat? From Odisha, purchased from Markanda. It cost him around rupees 6 lakhs. That boat cost was, what is the cost of that boat? 6 lakhs. From Odisha, he brought that. He borrowed the money from private lenders at a high rate of interest. How he got 6 lakhs? He doesn't have that much money, means he got that money from, he borrowed that money from private lenders. They take excess interest. Private lenders take much interest. He could not get a bank loan as he had no fixed assets. He could not get a bank loan. Why? Because 6 lakhs means amount, huge amount. So, bank doesn't give the, bank asks proof. Any asset proof, bank asks. So, Tata Rao doesn't have any assets. Because of that, he took money from private lenders. High interest. Even for daily fishing expenses, he has to get advances from middleman. He has to invest a minimum of 5,000 per week for diesel, wages and other expenses. Daily for one trip, he want to spend 5,000 rupees. For diesel, so many people are coming on the boat to work. So, for them also, he spent for that wages and other expenses for diesel, 5,000 rupees will be for first trip, one trip. Since he borrowed money from a middleman, Tata Rao has to sell the day's catch of fish to the middleman at the rate he fixes. This middleman fixes the rate of the fishes. So, he has to sell that fixes at the rate which the middleman fixes. By this time, the boat is ready for sailing and all the 20 members are on the boat. So, boat is ready and all the 20 members are going for fishing. They go up to 50 to 20 kilometers in the sea. How much far he has to go? They have to go 50 to 20 kilometers. They have to go for fishing on the sea. We will continue in the next class.